Too bad the fog didn't give us water, right? Tonight, Governor Newsom has declared a drought emergency in two counties, and it could be just the beginning. Sonoma and Mendocino counties now under a drought emergency. Nearly the entire state is in trouble right now, but the governor stopped short of declaring a statewide drought. And in Marin County, with the hills parched, ranchers are concerned that grass-fed cattle won't have enough to feed on. Ranchers are already forecasting losses with no rain in sight.
It's kind of scary to see, to witness it. This is only April, you know?
So 2014 was bad. This is going to be worse.
As conditions persist and present themselves, to add other counties to that list as necessary.
Meteorologist Darren Peck is in for Paul this evening. And Darren, you were saying the snow is melting at a record pace right now in the Sierra.
Yeah, Liz, on the other side of the state, I've got some unprecedented changes to tell you about in the Sierra snowpack just over the last 3 weeks. Looks great when you look at it from space, but you're only seeing the surface level of the snow. What you have to consider is how much water is being stored in that snowpack. That's what matters most to us. On April 1st, when we did our big snow survey, we were at 63% of average. We'd like more, but that doesn't sound all that bad. But in the last 3 weeks, that number has gone down to 37% of average. It should have stayed close to 63. We're just talking about what's the percent of water there in comparison to what average would be for today's date. We were at 63% then. That number should have tracked closely to that, but something happened over the last 3 weeks. And if you look at the Sierra as a whole, I know the dots are small on there, but each one of the red dots shows you a snow sensor which has recorded the largest decline in water content in the Sierra snowpack since we started keeping records on this stuff, at least 30 years. So we're breaking records in terms of losing the snowpack faster than we ever have. The primary culprit behind this? The temperatures. And if you look at what California has done for the last 3 weeks, the areas shaded deeply in red were well above average. You may remember around April 1st, many of us here we're in shorts and t-shirt weather, and so it all ties into the story of climate change, which we're doing a lot of coverage on this week, and that's probably one of the more notable discoveries of just this last week.
And Darren, you were saying the snow is melting at a record pace right now in the Sierra.
Yeah, Liz, on the other side of the state, I've got some unprecedented changes to tell you about in the Sierra snowpack just over the last 3 weeks. Looks great when you look at it from space, but you're only seeing the surface level of the snow. What you have to consider is how much water is being stored in that snowpack. That's what matters most to us. On April 1st, when we did our big snow survey, we were at 63% of average. We'd like more, but that doesn't sound all that bad. But in the last 3 weeks, that number has gone down to 37% of average. It should have stayed close to 63. We're just talking about what's the percent of water there in comparison to what average would be for today's date. We were at 63% then. That number should have tracked closely to that. But something happened over the last 3 weeks. And if you look at the Sierra as a whole, I know the dots are small on there, but each one of the red dots shows you a snow sensor which has recorded the largest decline in water content in the Sierra snowpack since we started keeping records on this stuff, at least 30 years. So we're breaking records in terms of losing the snowpack faster than we ever have. The primary culprit behind this? The temperatures. And if you look at what California has done for the last 3 weeks, the areas shaded deeply in red were well above average. You may remember around April 1st, many of us here, we're in shorts and t-shirt.